if Jesus is God, I would like you to show me one verse, only one statement anywhere in your Bible, any version of the Bible where Jesus says, I am God, or where he says, worship me. You see, the word God, the first time the God occurs in that verse, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. I'm asking, what is the Greek word there for God? You are a Christian of the Greek scriptures. You know Greek. You ought to know Greek, the basis of your religion. The manuscripts were all in Greek. Matthew, Mark, Luke, John, and the 27 books of the New Testament were only available in Greek. In the Greek language, what is the word for God? The word is theos. Theos in Greek means God, and the word there is hotheos. Hotheos means the God. Now, according to the system of the Western nations, when they have a proper noun, they start with the capital. Proper noun. Common noun, small g. Proper noun, capital G. God, for God. So there, in the translations, you have got God with a capital G. Accepted. That's your system. In Hebrew and in Greek, there is no such thing as capital letters, and there's no such thing as small letters. And in Arabic also, no capital letters, no small letters. But in your Western system, you have capital letters and you have small letters. So there, the word the God stands for God Almighty. So we have the capital G-O-D, God. And the word was God. That second word, God, in Greek, sir, is tontios. Tontios in Greek means a God. A God should have a small g. According to your system, a God means any God. That's not a proper noun. So you must have a small g. So I'm asking, why have you put a capital G again? Come on, explain. You are cheating somebody. First time, capital G, valid, acceptable. Second time, it should be a small g. Why have you put another capital G? You're creating a different meaning, that this is the God Almighty. A God means godly. Where did you get the small g's and the capital G's from? It's not in Hebrew, not in Greek. This is what you want to believe and what you want the people to believe. This is not honest translation. So I say again, in the words of Jesus, these are not the words of Jesus. What does he say? Jesus says, my Father is greater than I. I'm quoting him. My Father is greater than I. He says again, my Father is greater than all. He says again, I can of my own self do nothing. What you have been quoting was Hebrews and so on and so on. I said, what? Philippians and who else? I said, who is this? Philippians, Galatians, Corinthians, Thessalonians. Who is that? Who is it? Jesus? No, it's Paul, 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 Paul. I want to know what my master Jesus says. I love him. I respect him. I revere him. I want to follow him. But I want to know what he said. Give me his words. Not what somebody else, what he thinks, or what it ought to have meant, or what it was implied. Religion, salvation of my salvation does not depend upon people's interpretations, yours or mine, or anybody's. I want to know, what did the master say? He said, the word you hear, the words you hear are not mine, but the Father that sent me, he had given me a commandment, what I should say and what I should speak. Even as the Father had said unto me, so I speak. So what he spoke was the truth. Jesus, what he said is the truth. Maybe you understand things differently, but I'm prepared to abide by that. I'm prepared to put my neck on the guillotine. Chop it off as you like, but produce the authority of Jesus. That Jesus said, I am God. Jesus said, worship me. I said, simple English. I'm talking simple, basic English. I wanted the words of Jesus, where Jesus says, I hope you all understand this English I'm talking. Where Jesus says, I am God, where Jesus says, worship me. I hope you will bear this in mind in the next 10 minutes that the pastor has, where that he'll be able to quote, show me a verse where Jesus saying, I'm God, or where he says, worship me. And you'll never find it, because my neck is on the guillotine.